Well, the member for Jagajaga.
Thank you, Deputy Speaker. Well, I rise to speak on this bill because the Australian aged care system is in crisis. The Coalition government has neglected older Australians for the past 8 years, and we now have a Royal Commission that sets out for us just how damning that neglect is. Their record on aged care speaks volumes. Under this government, there's been a $1.7 billion cut from the sector. Nearly 11,000 deaths from people who were waiting for home care in the past year. 685 deaths from coronavirus during the pandemic. Chronic understaffing, malnutrition and neglect in facilities. The Royal Commission into Aged Care sets all of this out. It highlighted graphically the tragic outcomes of a system of neglect, of failures all round. And they've had 8 years to do something about it. 8 years where the Coalition government has neglected older Australians, neglected aged care residents and workers for 8 years. These are the people who built our country. These are our parents, our family members, our community members. What does it say about all of us? What does it say about the community we want that we are prepared to put up with these conditions? What does it say that this government is still failing to act on the recommendations of that damning Royal Commission? And it's a cliché to use the phrase damning reading, but it does describe the experience of reading the report of the Royal Commission into Aged Care Quality and Safety. Commissioner Linnell Briggs finds that an absence of government leadership and stewardship of the system meant that obvious and long-standing problems have not been dealt with. And that absence created a system that left Commissioner Briggs wondering whether, as a community, we'd lost our moral compass. So poor is the system now. So the Royal Commission was the government's chance. It is the government's chance, after 8 years of leadership failure, to reset and to build a system that respects older Australians. The Royal Commission made 148 recommendations, and the government's response to those recommendations is nothing short of disappointing. The government has delayed and rejected key recommendations, and some of the problems with the government's response include not reforming workforce issues, this huge issue that's sitting there. There was nothing in the government's response, there is nothing in the government's response, to improve wages for overstretched, undervalued aged care workers, the bedrock of our system. Funding commitments, they're gifting $3.2 billion to providers with no strings attached to ensure that this actually goes to actual care or better food, not into the pockets of unscrupulous providers. They've failed to clear the home care package waitlist of 100,000 people, and yet we know, and I know so many people in my community want to age at home. They've ignored the recommendation to require a nurse to be on duty 24/7 in residential care, something that's core to improving care. And they haven't implemented the main increase to mandatory care minutes in residential aged care. We know that staffing levels are central to so many of the quality problems in residential aged care, and yet this government's response ignores the fact that the workforce we rely on to care for people in residential aged care is underpaid. They're not supported to have a long-term career. They're not supported to have a job that pays them decent conditions. And we see the results of this all round. During the pandemic, we've seen what that means for workers having to work across multiple facilities when they're not vaccinated, when they're having to go between facilities, and the risk that that creates for both these workers and for people in those facilities. In my own community, I know one of the things that people have been most concerned about at the start of this winter, as Melbourne was in its fourth lockdown, was the fact that aged care workers were not vaccinated. And aged care workers were left without any supplementary payments that meant that they were able to work at just one facility instead of working across facilities. After what we endured last year in Melbourne, after all the deaths we saw in aged care, after all the workers we saw who were put at risk, this government failed to vaccinate them. It failed to put in place the plans that would allow them to just work in one facility. And that goes to this government's whole attitude towards the aged care system. It's a hands-off, not my responsibility, nothing to see here, nothing to fix here. Well, it's not good enough. You are leaving, this government is leaving aged care workers, they are leaving aged care residents out of the supports they need, out of the type of support and system we should have in a country that truly values our older Australians. We should not be scared about a future of entering aged care, and yet that is where most members of our community are. I know this. They come and tell me. They tell me, I don't want my mum and dad to go in there. I've seen what happens. They're scared. The people who are entering those facilities are scared. They should not be. And yet this government is failing to respond to the recommendations of the Royal Commission. It is failing to put in place the wholesale change, the real change, that will fix this system, that will value this system going forward. Well, Labor knows that our aged care system needs fixing. We know that it's broken. We know it needs fixing, and we will do the work to fix it. We will make sure that aged care residents are valued. We will make sure that aged care workers are paid as they should be. We will make sure that this is a system that works for people, not for providers and for their profits. We will make sure this Royal Commission does not go to waste and that older Australians are treated with the dignity and respect they should be. So while it's positive in this bill that there are amendments relating to restrictive practices, while it's positive that we have some amendments relating to home care assurance reviews, and that we have amendments relating to the Aged Care Financing Authority, it's not enough. We deserve better. From the beginning of this year, I know how hard people in my community and how difficult it's been for them looking at this situation with aged care roll out again, situation of unvaccinated workers, of residents at risk, and of a system that's not getting the fix that it needs. This government cannot drag the chain anymore. It cannot fail to respond as it should. It must respond to all the recommendations. It must fix our aged care system.
I thank the member for